You may have watched or read some news or some YouTube videos with the title of Bitcoin's energy problem, but is Bitcoin actually bad for the environment? Well, yes, kind of. But first, let's talk about what Bitcoin actually is. Bitcoin was the first real cryptocurrency in the world, allowing people to transfer money on a decentralized network online. When a transaction happens on the network, it gets added to a public ledger, the blockchain, a chunk at a time called a block. These blocks have to be verified by miners around the world every 10 minutes or so. These miners verify these blocks by solving complex math equations. These problems are really hard to solve where the computer actually has to do so many calculations, it brute forces the algorithm. The top mining computer can guess or hash 140 trillion times a second. For reference, in 2014, Ken Sheriff posted a video where he worked out the algorithm by hand and estimates that he could do 2/3 of a single hash a day. As it's really easy to see, solving the Bitcoin hash function SHA-256 is actually very difficult. However, every 10 minutes, a lucky miner gets the block reward of 6.25 Bitcoins currently, about $250,000 as of March 2022. With stakes this high, nearly everyone around the world wants a slice of this crypto pie. However, these mining computers can use a lot of energy, like 3,000 watts per miner. In this mining farm in Rockdale, Texas, they can fit 30,000 miners in one building. Doing some simple napkin math and considering you can find mines like this all around the world, you can see that the Bitcoin network uses a lot of energy. Funny enough, about half the energy used in large-scale mining operations actually comes from air conditioning to keep the computers cool, which is often why you see mines in colder climates, but that's besides the point. The website digitonomous.net estimates that the Bitcoin network uses nearly 200 terawatt hours a year, which is comparable to the annual use of the entirety of Thailand. This means if Bitcoin was a country, it would be number 23 in energy consumption out of all the countries in the world. Google, yeah, like that Google with YouTube and stuff, only uses 12.4 terawatt hours annually throughout the entire company. So you can see a lot of energy is used on Bitcoin. I think it's logical to compare Bitcoin to traditional banking, as that is something it wants to compete with. So how much more energy does Bitcoin use compared to like a Visa transaction? Well, this doesn't paint a good picture for Bitcoin either, considering you can have about 1.5 million Visa transactions for the same energy it takes to verify one Bitcoin transaction. So we get it. Bitcoin uses a relatively large chunk of the world's energy relative to the amount of people that use it. But what about renewable energy? We see articles all the time talking about mines that use solar panels to power it, some use hydropower from dams. I even read online once that they use a volcano for electricity in one place. In fact, a lot of energy for the Bitcoin network is green. However, it's not enough. People estimate that 40% of the energy used comes from green sources. For example, it seems like miners love the hydroelectric dams in China, but that means 60% of the energy comes from dirty coal or other fossil fuels. And that's the problem with Bitcoin, this 60%. The huge demand for energy leads these mining companies to go after the cheapest source of energy, which tends to be not very environmentally friendly. In fact, what inspired this video was a couple articles talking about how mining operations reopened coal-fired power plants, one in New York and one in Kentucky. When companies take steps into these directions, it's pretty easy and simple to say Bitcoin isn't good for the planet. One topic that I think isn't covered enough is the ewaste part of the Bitcoin equation. Bitcoin mining farms use special mining devices called ASICs, or application-specific integrated circuits. ASICs are computers that can do one thing and one thing only, and in this case, mine Bitcoin. As Bitcoin's mining difficulty has increased over time, these ASIC machines have become relatively less and less powerful over time until they are considered obsolete. ASICs and bid mining operations are usually replaced in only 3 to 4 years, due to the fact that they cost more in electricity than they are capable of mining. However, you can assume some mining farms replace their machines faster than that to optimize profits. Since this is standard 4 years before the machine becomes useless, a lot of scrap and trash gets created. It's estimated that almost 40 metric tons of e-waste gets made just from the Bitcoin network every year. This means that every single Bitcoin transaction contributes 410 grams of e-waste. Considering that only 20% of all global e-waste gets recycled, landfills will be covered with mining equipment as long as this trend of replacing miners every few years continues, which it will. E-waste is a pretty complex issue as you have to consider all of the different environmental factors with these electronics. Mining gold and silicon pollutes the soil and rivers nearby, while at the same time we all know plastics are virtually indestructible. Also, the fact that many materials found in electronics can be toxic, And that's not even talking about transporting all of these different materials around and manufacturing them. But overall, e-waste is not good, and Bitcoin objectively creates a lot of it. But it's not just Bitcoin. A lot of other cryptocurrencies are affecting the environment in the same way as Bitcoin. I'm only talking about Bitcoin as it makes the title of the video more clickable, and overall lets more people understand and appreciate what I'm trying to say. But this isn't a Bitcoin exclusive problem. In fact, when you think about mining, you probably think of individuals mining Ethereum in their basement. But everything I said applies to them too. So yeah, Bitcoin isn't technically the best thing for the environment. However, there are a lot of other things we do, such as deforestation or raising an absurd amount of cattle that is significantly worse for the environment. What about the smog that hovers over some of the world's most populated cities from the hundreds of thousands of cars we drive? These are their own individual problems that need to be addressed in their own way, but being around 1% of the global energy consumption doesn't mean that this isn't an insignificant impact to our environment. Considering the fact that there are countless other cryptocurrencies that we could use that use energy infinitely more efficient through proof of staking and other efficiency upgrades compared to the Bitcoin network, is having your own personal computer mine in the background while you aren't using it the worst thing in the planet? No. But it's not the best. We are exploiting the environment for our own gain. Although I think Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are going to be relevant for some time, I think all of us should recognize every now and then what it is doing to our environment.